EnWave is developing a brand new dehydration technology, which we believe is a chance to change the way the world fundamentally drives many different products, from the food to the biological industry. We've been developing this technology with our very first commercial agreements recently being signed. In terms of the technology itself, it's called radiant energy vacuum, and it's a way to dry products using a microwave energy under vacuum, where you get a very high quality products retaining nutrients, flavors, colors. The technology was developed at the University of British Columbia by Dr. Tim Durance and is much cheaper, faster, better in terms of quality than many of the incumbent technologies currently in the drying industry. So we are looking to develop through a very large global partnership with major world leading companies in the food and pharmaceutical markets, technology into large commercial applications. If you look at the market today, there's really three primary technologies used in the drying industry. Spray drying and air drying are large-scale technologies that are continuous. They're very, very efficient. They do large throughputs. And the difficulty with those technologies is that they expose the materials to both heat and oxygen, which tends to damage the flavors, the nutrients, the colors. So they can't be used in all applications, particularly heat-sensitive ones. So about 50 years ago, the world created another method called freeze-drying or lyophilization. And this method actually freezes the material and gradually sublimates the liquid out over many, many hours. It actually preserves the quality of the product better, but it's very expensive in both capital, energy, labor, and very, very slow. Our method is called radiant energy vacuum. And what we've done is we've used a method where we take vacuum and bring the boiling point from all the way from 100 degrees down to room temperature or even into the frozen state. And we apply a microwave radiant energy, which is very efficient. And we dry in this gentle environment at a very, very fast rate the product, allowing us to retain excellent nutrients, colors, flavors, textures, but doing it and drying it at a much faster rate than conventional methods. EnWave this year has had a major first breakthrough. We signed in May last year a commercial agreement with a company called Milne Fruits. A company that's been around the U.S. market since the 1950s. Their primary business has been in fruit juices, fruit purees, fresh fruits. And now, since buying our technology, they're launching a new group of fruit snacks for berries, blueberries, blackberries, raspberries, and fruit powders to replace purees, which they've done for many years. Milne started their very first plant and entered commercial production just in April this year. So we're very excited to see them move forward. They're covering over 90% of the U.S. market with their distribution network, as well as Eastern Canada. So this is the first big breakthrough for EnWave technology in the United States and our first major commercial partner. So we're very excited by that. Over the past few years, we've entered research agreements, collaboration agreements with companies as diverse as Nestle and Kellogg's, Hormel, major global companies, and Merck, which is a pharmaceutical company, which is a global leader in that market. Through these partnerships, there's a lot of testing of EnWave technology for various applications that would allow us to break open new markets. We work with these companies so that they can look at ways to make improvements or new brands or cost improvements in currently their drying methods. We made another major breakthrough in June recently when we announced the first royalty license agreement with one of the partners. What this has done is it allowed them to take one of our pilot machines, and after a successful R&D phase, they're now going to be doing a much broader market evaluation, selling commercially, trying to assess pricing, with the goal of finalizing a commercial license with commercial orders for technology in 2013. So we're very, very excited by the prospects of this. In addition, we feel there's others that are getting closer to moving forward. So we hope towards the second half of this year that we can see additional traction with some of these larger partners in terms of looking into the next commercial steps. We also have a significant number of other newer companies that are testing that haven't been announced yet as partners that we hope to be able to discuss in the future as their testing enters us closer to collaboration and research agreements. Another major announcement that we just made was the agreement to acquire a 75.1% interest in the Honbinder GmbH company. For 3 years we've worked with this Binder group in terms of strategic relationship, We acquired some of their patents that were related to the company in 2010, and now we've decided to move forward to fully integrate the companies through this acquisition. And EnWave really has a lot of strength in marketing, in innovation, in patents. And Binder is a very, very strong machine builder. It's been building conventional dryers since the 50s, vacuum microwave tray methods in the 2000s. And we really, together with their innovation and building expertise and turnkey plant design expertise and our innovation, will create a very strong platform to service our customers. And we're very excited. We believe it's a very good transaction for EnWave. It allows us to become accretive, start generating larger revenue sources from the building side, and give our customers a better opportunity to get customized technology for different applications. If you look at historically, companies that are positioned with disruptive technology in very large market sectors, which I believe we are, if they can be successful at bringing the commercialization of that into wide ranges of the market, you can see very, very good valuation potential. And I believe the fact that we've attracted some very high quality potential partners, we're showing that we can build commercial scale, industrial scale technology. I think it's a big step for us in the right direction. And we really have such a wide diversity of risk because we have so many different areas we're testing that you're not relying as an investor on only one area. And at the same time, many of our partners have multiple areas where we see them able to use the technology. So we've got an opportunity that could be very, very large in scale. And if our royalty method can be successfully implemented across these different areas, it also gives a chance for very high margin revenue streams, which is very, very important. So we believe we are now, as we complete the Binder acquisition as well, going to be clearly the world's leading company in the development of vacuum microwave technology. And we believe this kind of technology is poised to really break open and deliver major disruption to the current drying industry.